You're on camera. Where are you going? Nick is in deep thought, learning from superior intellected beings. Simulate rock, I would imagine.
I got one. Do I need a map?
Nothing. Huh? That's for style, Nick. Style. Damn right, style. Say something, Nick. Huh?
Looks like a toy.
For the turtle, probably.
Look at that big mama.
That tells you the horizon line as well as the center mark. You can also have other rulers you can put on there that only exist too. You gotta remember, this thing's recording in such a big picture, you gotta know where the center is. But it doesn't show up on the film, of course. Wow. It's a whole lot of water. You want to? I'll let you. I'll pay a ticket to see you do it.
Is that a little coat for your camera?
It's what?
A little coat for your camera?
It's a microphone. It's a windsock.
Is that what that is?
Uh-huh. Oh. Deeper than it looks.
What does it do? Help to take some of the sound out or something?
If you're in windy environments.
Filters.
Yeah.
Filters.
Yeah, so if you're in windy environments, the microphone will pick up the glowing sound.
All right, well, that makes sense.
It's just on there. Yeah. Obviously, there's no wind in here.
Uh-huh. No, I just saw it and thought that I'd make a little joke. It was a little coat. The camera. Yeah.
What?
I like that. Huh?
Yeah, it's really clean. Huh? Oh yeah, always. You start with the basics. Make the rock first and add the tree there. It looks like it's where you can go through for kids. Go ahead and go through. Come on, go ahead. I'll film you.
Go get in there.
Were you afraid you're gonna meet a bully in there? You're gonna make you give you your milk money? More frogs. Watching him. You're running out of room, alligator. What you gonna do?
Hey, don't you walk away.
Roger, little big.
Look amazing.
I just loaded
me. And of course, there's the Nicholas alligator. Just a floating.
That one looks like just floating. He's just floating backwards.
Yeah, he was moving a minute ago. There's a lot of Nicholas fish around here. DVR and something like that ever on there. Your room.
See, I got
entertaining things to do. So do they. Well, what's entertaining in there?
If they even require something with me.
I don't like the one staring at me.
They were looking right at me.
Like that one?
Huh?
Like that one?
That's really cool.
Good morning.
So much water.
Good morning.
How are you?
Pretty good.
Do you guys have any questions about anything you see? Or
nah.
If you have anything in the habitat or the gallery, just let me know.
All right.
You got a bigger camera than me. Well, it depends on even if it's high def or not. If it's not high def, it doesn't matter how big it is. What's in there?
I don't see anything.
I don't see anything.
Guess it's empty.
Kind of too close to the sign to take a picture now.
That's gotta be.
They wouldn't lie to me. Little Nemo fish. Nemo fish. Look at the colors, huh?
So, but he was
more. I'm sure he said the same thing about you. Oh, not the water spiders. Y'all don't like the water spiders.
I didn't know there was any.
They're crabs, but this breed always reminds me of spiders. Seen something like that. See it?
Yeah.
You're on the other side.
Thank you.
sea dragon, or weedy sea dragon.
So let you know, whales are not here, blue whales.
Don't worry. Yep, they always are. For strength. Huh? Well, that's for deep sea.
Probably 2 or 3.
Possible. These little people like Nicholas. Seems to like 20 of you in there. No whales. Research submersible clearly at the George Aquarium, Harvard Branch Oceanographic Institution in Fort Pierce, Florida. It was originally built in 1970. Well, it's a different size. Oceanographics. You ain't gonna fit a blue whale. You just go, woo, smash. Yeah, it's gone.
Certified to operate at depths of up to 1,000 feet, able to reach a speed of 3 knots, Clelia is used for research purposes. During her exploration, she's equipped with a manipulator on a lift of 121 pounds, and her tasks include collecting sediment samples and biological specimens, providing photo and video documentation, and completing environmental and archaeological surveys. Clelia is capable of carrying a marine person
to
scientists and one pilot.
Okay. I'm gonna get dizzy doing this with that. That better not be the glass cracking. These are the cool ones. These are the ones that can go around corners. The straight ones, no.
Sharks over here.
Yeah.
darker one. That's the one. There's another one over there. There's another one over there.
Oh.
That would be nice. Lose your balance on this one.
Big fish.
Look at it. Please step off. I can't fit into the crab. I'm all dizzy. Look at them.
Is the next classroom starting in November?
You want?
Is that this place?
Is what? Is what what?
It says Ocean Voyage.
Probably the fish in this tank, right? You think? They don't go many places, do you?
We need to get some Jurassic Park music in here.
Yeah.
Raise your hand.
Close the question.
We were using it Huh? They all have parents. Let's zoom in on them cheap. Wow. Jesus. How'd you have to be swimming with that thing in the water?
That would suck.
Yeah, I mean, that's insane. That's why I don't like the ocean.
Is that a straight mouth or curved?
Is all that crap's in there somewhere? As long as they kept them fed, I think they're okay.
Does that black tips?
As long as they kept them fed, I'm sure they'd be okay.
You're right. What about that one?
Where's the Nicholas? Sorry, we just can't figure out how to make this one interesting. Got you again. Huh? Be worried about it. Looks like oil and water. It's kind of like what oil does. It gets all stringy like that. Oh, it is an orange clownfish. That is what Nemo was based on.
And that was, whatever her name was over there.
Who?
The other fish.
You know, I haven't actually seen that movie, right? You know, not four.
Hmm.
body has a weird obsession. It's like Nick's brain in here.
Hello, welcome everyone. Come on inside. Come on down here in the open space. You can stand alongside the walls here, and I'm going to give you some information about some of the artifacts that you've seen here. Of course, this is your first stop here at the World of Coca-Cola. My name is Shakandra, and I'll be your guide for the first two rooms. After this room, we're going to go into the next room and watch a film called Inside the Happiness Factory. It's a 6-minute documentary. It's called Inside the Happiness Factory because it's going to take you inside the Coca-Cola vending machine and show you what happens when you press your money inside of that machine. Then we're going to go inside of the hub area. The hub is where you'll begin your self-guided journey through the building. And that's when you need your guide maps the most. If you didn't get a guide map, we have plenty in the hub area. So you can grab one up when you get in that area. And we're back to this area. How's everybody doing today? Good? Yeah. A little rainy, but it's still good. Now, who's been here before? Who's never been here before, okay? All right, wonderful. That was good. Anybody ever been to our old building, too? Good, wonderful. Now, our old building was near the underground of Atlanta. We opened that one in 1990, and then we came over here in May of 2007, so we've been here for about 2 years or so. And this room is one of the differences between the two buildings. It's called the Coca-Cola Loft because everything you see in here is all about Coca-Cola Classic. And everything you see in here is an original, one-of-a-kind thing as well, so there are no duplicates in here. We have over 20 different countries and 16 different languages located in this room. And above my head, you'll see monitors called Coke by the Numbers. Shows you a number, and then it begins to tell you what that number means to Coca-Cola and some of its brands. So you'll see different years, different dates, different amounts up there, prices. Just fun facts told through numbers right there above my head on those monitors. We have our oldest artifact in here from 1896. It's the only one in here from the 1800s, and it's located over here in this display case. Anybody know which one it is? Raise your hand if you think you know. Delivery truck? No, it's not the truck. Good guess. You're right there, yeah, as well. The tray? It's not the tray? You're talking about this tray over here? Yeah, it's not the tray. Good guess. Still in the right area. Is the little base thing over here? Yes, it is. Wonderful. Yay! You guys give him a little bit of applause right here. Yay! And that serve dispenser that he pointed out is what we use all the way to the 1900s. Now, we had someone called a soda jerk who was a young boy who would have syrup inside of the bowl. He would get your glass and place a bunch of here. About this much syrup would go into your glass, and then you would mix it with carbonated water, and you'd have a Coca-Cola beverage to drink. After this method, we then used a Dole Jr. that's above our heads. It's made the amount of syrup that went inside of the glass more precise. I'll give you a sticker right over here because you guessed the right answer. Wonderful. Place it on your forehead if you like. There you go. You're welcome. Now we have right over here our second oldest artifact from 1905. It says, drink Coca-Cola 5 cents. In 1886 all the way to 1956, it was just 5 cents to get a Coca-Cola. You guys still wish it was 5 cents today? Yeah, that'd be pretty nice. Yeah. Down here, there's a six-pack carrying case. You could have gotten a whole six-pack of Coca-Cola in the 30s for just 25 cents, but you had to be sure to bring back your empty bottles, Coca-Cola bottles, along with the carrying case to get your refill there. Then there's right over here, there's a painting called Barefoot Boy. It's a Norman Rockwell original painting. So this is our most valuable artifact in this room. But actually, Norman Rockwell commissioned 6 paintings for Coca-Cola. This one here from 1931, and we also have another one in Milestones of Refreshments from 1934 called Carry Me Back to Old Virginia. And then we have another one at our corporate headquarters, and the other 3 paintings are missing. So if you come across one of those, you should let us know. Might get to retire a little early. Now we also have over here some Coca-Cola Hip Hugger Beach Pants. These are from the 70s. Would you guys wear a pair of them today? They're kind of cute. 1972, you could have owned those pants, a matching hat and bag, and you would have gotten all of that for just $2.98, plus a proof of purchase. Someone did come in here wearing those pants, and she had on a matching jacket, so people took more pictures of her than anything else in our building. We also have over here from the 70s an ad that features Raquel Welch, and she has on the dynamic ribbon that we came out with. This is our new look. It was our new look for our campaign ads. It's right there on her bracelet, her ring, and also on her belt. This is the actual belt bracelet she's wearing in the picture. They say that she's about 69, and she still looks this good because she drinks so much Coca-Cola. Maybe not. We also have right here from Beijing the 2008 Olympic can, and we play a big part with the Olympics. We started our partnership with them in 1928. We sent over some Coca-Cola to Amsterdam, and we've been doing things for them for the Olympics ever since. We have Olympic items and milestones or refreshments. We have Olympic torches that you'll get to carry. You'll get to carry one of those torches today. And down here we have 2009 summer fun cans. Those are our newest items. Anybody seen this in the stores? No? We brought them out at the beginning of the summer. I'm not sure they're out there now, but we started with the glasses down here and ended with the boogie board that's right up here. You could have collected them all. 2009 summer fun cans there. Up here we have festoons. This is a festoon from the 20s, and this is a festoon from the 40s. And then we have a festoon over here. It's from the 30s here. And we actually hang festoons above soda fountains around these times. And that's where you got your Coca-Cola and the different pharmacies that you went to. We also have a festoon over here from 1933 with MGM leading ladies up there, superstars, poor lovely ladies up there. Right here in the front, you see Joan Crawford. She's probably the most well-known one up there. We also have Joan Crawford on the back wall and on the poster over here in the corner, which is also from 1933, with Clark Gable. Anybody know what Clark Gable was most known for? What movie? Gone with the Wind, yes, wonderful. And we actually have her back here, have him back here posing with Joan Crawford with that drink in their hands. And also on the back wall, if you look right over here, you see Play Refresh, where it says Play Refresh for football players. This is from 1953. And we have another one over here, Graham W. Jackson. That's from 1953. He was a famous musician. These are two of the first African-American ads that we had. And above Graham W. Jackson, we have Azure Rai, famous star from India there, offering you Coca-Cola. We have different countries and different languages on this back wall too. So I'd like to point out over here to the right, a little bit to the right, you see Treat Coca-Cola with the man alone on the sand. And right there beside that one, you'll see the two women drink with a gentleman that says Mock Mall Cola, Treat Coca-Cola as well. And Mock Mall Cola is saying take a break, and of course drink is not a typo, it means drink. So those two are from Germany there. Look all the way up to the top, you'll see silver letters that spell out the Coca-Cola company, and then they have some dings and scratches on them because they hang outside of our corporate building from 1919 all the way to 1979. And the building is still over there, just a few blocks from here. And instead of the silver letters, we now have red letters that spell out Coca-Cola in the building. Now we do have our largest artifact over here in the corner to the left. So if you take a look over here, you'll see the big red bottle opener right here. And it used to be 16 feet long and 5 feet wide at the base, very big. But we cut it down, we had to cut it down and bring it in here. And it used to hang outside of our billboard on I-75 heading north here in Atlanta in 2006. So some of you probably had seen that from here. Who's from Atlanta here, anybody? Yeah, had you seen that going I-75 north in town? Probably, yeah. We also have right over here a big red sign right here that says live on the coast side of life, and then characters are exploding out of the bottle. And those are our Happiness Factory characters that you're going to meet in the next room of the film called Inside the Happiness Factory once again. And they're also featured in 2007 Super Bowl commercial, which is actually what this film that you're going to watch in a second is derived from. The one where the boy walks up to the machine and places money inside, and the characters create the ball in the ball of parade. And then we also have another one far over here. Well, we have a poster with the characters again far over here to the right from the 2008 Super Bowl commercial. And in that commercial, the characters, they grew very sleepy, but they gave them some Coca-Cola and they lightened up and had a good time in the Happiness Factory. But right there beside the bottle, you'll see Open Happiness. That's our new slogan, our new campaign ad slogan. We use that on a lot of different commercials and things, a lot of different ads, and you probably have seen those words. We should use those words to open these doors. So in just a second, these lights are going to start flashing, the one over here and also over here above these doors here. That lets us know it's time to go inside of the Happiness Factory, and I'm going to actually count to three. I want everyone to say open happiness so we can open the doors to happiness and make our way inside. And as we look around and take pictures of the different items in here, if you have, I'll be happy to answer anything that you have questions about. All right, let's just wait. It'll be just a second.
Thank you.
next on three. One, two, three. Open happiness. All right, you open the doors to happiness. Let's go inside.
Exiting at the bottom of the theater after the movie.
Yes, welcome everyone inside of the Happiness Factory Theater. You can have a seat wherever you like. All the seats are great seats because they're red and also because they're very comfortable. So just come on in and have a seat. You can exit near the bottom of the theater so you can come on down as far as you feel comfortable. All right. And I hope you guys brought your smiles along with you as you came through the doors inside the Happiness Factory. We have to be a little bit happy. Are you guys happy, pretty much? Yeah, happy, all right. We're going to immerse you into an out-of-this-world experience we like to call Inside the Happiness Factory, and we're gonna take you inside of a Coca-Cola vending machine because we wanna show you what happens when you place your money inside of that machine. And we're gonna show you some characters. They're here to actually show you how they place love, magic, and happiness into each and every bottle of Coca-Cola that you receive. And these characters are actual Coca-Cola employee voiceovers, which is very neat. So go through the building and keep your ears open and see if you can recognize a voice or two. If you can recognize a voice, we'll give you a free bottle of Coca-Cola at the end of your journey today. And if you can't recognize a voice, you'll still get a free bottle of Coca-Cola at the end of your journey. Now we're going to show you how to make that bottle in Bottleworks. This is a very slow, very small bottling plant. It's designed for you to see the exact process of making an 8-ounce glass bottle of Coke. And then we have a lot more things to show you. But I'll give you some more information about your journey through the building after the film. And of course, you have your guide maps as well. So we're going to go ahead, sit back, relax. We're going to enjoy this film here and just refrain from any videotaping or photography during the movie. Aww. All right, thank you.
Oh God. That's not the creepiest damn thing you've ever seen. Oh God, it's coming at you, Nick. Yeah, that thing's creepy as hell. Still creeping me the hell out, dude. Look at the head. Oh, he sees me again. He's looking at me, Nick. Go get my gun.
Cola being produced and packaged in 8-ounce glass bottles, especially designed for the world of Coca-Cola.
What?
And it starts here.
It was clear that that didn't cost.
Are we allowed to film in here?
Yeah.
Okay. Making sure. The key card would suggest no. I don't care how it's made, just give me a go.
What?
You what?
They have it on camera.
Oh. Well, I got them on camera. Look at all this crap.
Please kill me. Please kill me. Please.
Oh crap.
Isn't that the old style?
No, just so you're talking about the really successful piece of
cat. Yeah, the older bottles where they would shatter a lot easier. That is a bottle, or it's the cap on the top of the bottle. I don't know.
It looks Japanese.
Japanese or Chinese. Of course. Or Taiwanese or something.
Logan, yeah.
So thirsty.
No coke.
Definitely the worst one.
Why'd you make me cut it?
Tasted of acid.
It does taste acid.
It really does.
It tears up the skin. It went right through it. Just like, tear up the throat and everything.
I'm sure one fell at some point.
Yeah, but I'm saying like every claw.
Yeah, right. Just time. Every single. Ah.
You're not going anywhere until you tell me what a prison bill is. He's like, bald. Careless ape like creature that is in North America. Because you either walk on it or you don't.
I'll do this to you guys, okay?
Sure aren't doing much. I didn't know they're just gonna be loose in here. You can wear that. Oh, I got crapped on. Heaven right there. Napping.
Wake up.
Elephants aren't very agile.
What about the stampedes?
What about them?
They can just run through things.
That's thousands of elephants. Or hundreds. No one did.
Is that a lion or a lion?
Yeah, it's one up on top.
No, no, the one doing all that screaming.
I think that's echoing. Possibly.
It doesn't look like he's making any noise, though.
I mean, he's kind of doing it in sync, but not anymore.
Not
an ostrich. Not an ostrich, but definitely a bird of some sort.
Yeah, because I always thought that ostriches were bigger than
that. Yeah. Looks like it's related, the legs and body shape.
Probably just bull.
Very possibly.
Oh, you want to test it?
Hmm? Want to do what?
Let's see.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Big Mom. Why did not see us?
Good to see you.
Wait. You want mommy? What does mommy do?
What am I doing?
Hey, John, get in the middle.
Me?
Are you not going?
I wouldn't be able to.
Right back, too.
I imagine it has to do with how they're not turning, but I'm not sure.
Gorilla could get over that. If he really wanted to.
Possibly. I'm sure they know what they're doing.
Don't want out.
You will. Can't afford that.
I have three brothers, Larry, Moe, and Curly.
Yeah.
And we had them in with a couple of little muntjac, which are little tiny barking deer. And they just used to love to harass the deer. And so they finally, it got too bad and they took the deer out. So then they started, you know, getting a little rough with each other. And Larry, was sick for a while. And he was off exhibit. And when he came back, the other two started picking on him. So they decided, well, it's time for them to go. So they sent the other two to two other zoos to breed. And then poor old Mo was all by himself here. He was not a happy camper. He was.
They don't want to be together. They're only together.
For me.
Yep. Which is an early. Social interaction they have is once a year for mating, but
they don't like people.
For the males and females.
Uh-oh. He heard me.
He got offended.
He just a little kind of
got offended when you said that. There's a head. It's getting hot.
That it is, Nick.
Wasn't this bad early?
Yeah, it was.
It was?
Mm-hmm.
Well, how come it just started getting hot?
Because you're doing stuff now.
I was doing something. I think all those things have a zoom.
Well, look at this. Wait. Let's one. Yeah. Can you?